8 set. What now?
I shall enter the cage. You must chain me inside. The bars are made of an alloy that will prevent me from transforming into mist.
Kinda thought you wouldn't want to.
I shall be in great pain. My sole thought being to stop that pain. I cannot know what I will do. We must hurry. The beasts have caught the scent. Also, my head started spinning.
That the blood?
Someone who's never experienced a vampire's bloodlust does not know the true meaning of thirst.
Maybe we need a safe word. You know, something you'll say when you can't take it anymore.
And what would you do once I uttered it?
Don't know. Calm you down. Somehow.
Please. You won't be able to. We must forge through this. That is all.
more coming.
Thank you. Hold on, I'll let you out.
Finish it in this state. Tell me how. I'll help you. Any better?
Far from ideal. And some time must pass before I fully recover. But yes, a bit better, thank you.
Never expected it to be like that. You didn't tell me.
We need not discuss it.
But we do. Because if I'd known you were going to subject yourself to torture...
What would you have done?
Found Dedlof some other way.
I did not wish you to use any other way. Did that occur to you?
No. Because I thought no being would ever willingly subject itself to that kind of pain. You vampires aren't any different from us in that regard.
I told you. The pain is my way of paying my debt. The enormous debt I owe Dedlof. If I had to do it again, I would in a heartbeat.
Resonance. It's ready.
Are you certain you followed the formula? The proportions were exact, the brewing time precise. This is important, Geralt. The slightest deviation could cost even a witcher dearly.
Relax. Got some experience brewing potions.
Very well. In that case, let's begin.
Excuse me. I shall only take a moment.
You jumped the queue, sir.
But Count, sir, you must understand. I've a meeting. The Count...
Sir, you were next. Please, take a seat. This gentleman was here first. Step down or you shall regret it.
Ah, failed to realize he was your friend, Count.
It was then I ordered him to give up his seat and step off the stand. If only you'd seen his face. We got him good, didn't we, Dedlof? And then Mother insisted we buy the mill. Curious, eh? But at least I've a yarn to spin for friends and associates.
Forgive me.
What?
Awake at last. You ride like a squirrel caught in a snare. I'd begun to fear they were death throes, that you'd departed.
Sure wasn't pleasant, but it worked.
What did you see?
Delacroix. His death did not come easy. Seems Dedlaf had made friends with him. Still killed him, and chopped up his corpse. And he was overcome with fury, remorse, cut off the hand that had committed the murder.
Interesting. And entirely unlike the Dedlaf I know. See anything else?
Saw a moment. Delacroix did something selfless. Was kind to Dedlaf. Guess it could have been the start of their friendship.
Why the uncertainty?
Nothing extraordinary about it. Normal, everyday situation, really. Visions were supposed to issue from strong emotions.
Clearly the situation provoked such emotions in Dedlaf. Keep in mind, he did later murder Delacroix.
Killing someone who's grown dear to us, it's bound to elicit strong emotion. Vampires are no different in that regard. Did you see anything else?
There was something. Showed up twice in the vision. A bootblack stand. Dedlaf first met Delacroix there. Went back after the murder, actually.
Peculiar.
Stand was somewhere in the port district. And the bootblack acted as if he knew Dedlaf.
That would be even odder. Perhaps we should have a chat with the lad. Though I would expect no breakthroughs.
It's our only lead. I'll go talk to him. Coming with.
I shall join you later if it's no trouble. I don't yet feel strong enough to venture out.
That's fair. Rest up. Be back as soon as I learn anything.
flitters. The deceased's corpse was completely mutilated. All that remained of the nose was a hole clotted with blood. One eye socket had been chewed beyond all recognition. The mandible had been torn off. Seeing this, Sergeant Philvate vomited profusely and the administration of smelling salts was required. The investigation has been discontinued and the deed attributed to a supernatural being. Fragment of a Totus Ring Ducal Guard report. Flighters are classified as lesser vampires. Though weaker than the rest of their ilk in every aspect from the physiomagic to the physiognomic, they should not be underestimated, for they are very, very dangerous. Flighters cannot be mistaken for any other creature, with their wide, toothy jaws, flat, unpleasant faces and completely hairless, often warty bodies. These vampires mainly fight with their teeth and claws, flailing them blindly and not stopping even when their victim is already dead. Even a solitary flighter is strong enough to take down a trained soldier. Compared to other vampires, flighters display meager intelligence, seen most clearly in the mindless rage which causes them to try with all their might to attack and tear to shreds any weaker being.
What now, you piece of filth?
This up if I want to get rid of the Endriggers.